In India, the street is often a lively, vibrant place, sometimes with people performing religious rituals here, an everyday market taking place, neighborhood festivals taking place along busy thoroughfares, and at other times, an amusement ride being set up. In the city of Bangalore, one finds that a major arterial road of the city is pedestrianized for 2 days in a year for the Peanut Fair, which is both a periodic marketplace and a cultural festival. The fair, colloquially called the Kadle Kai Parishe, has taken place every year for the past 500 years. The fair began as a coming together of peanut growers to offer their first crop to the Bull Temple. Today, it is not just religious belief, but also business opportunity that attracts people to Bangalore, and more than 200 peanut growers and traders from the surrounding villages participate in this fair. One finds that vendors situate themselves informally on the street in spaces for which they have no formal rights. In the 12th century, Bangalore was itself a village, but is today the fifth largest metropolis in India with a population of about 8.5 million. The Peanut Fair and Bull Temple Road have always been part of a planned neighborhood of the city. In 1898, when a plague hit Bangalore, Baswangudi became the location of the plague camp. Soon after, it was decided to plan a new layout on the 440 acres of land here, that is promoted as a model hygienic suburb. Today, the entire stretch of Bull Temple Road is pedestrianized during the Peanut Fair. Vehicular traffic is rerouted and security arrangements are made as the fair attracts visitors from all over the city and from neighboring villages and towns. The residents play an essential role in the process of facilitation by being extremely tolerant of the inconveniences caused by the changes in street usage during the fair. The access to the temple, to private residences, and to educational institutions along this road is affected for almost a week. The residents and visitors neither complain nor expect the situation to be any different. In the history of trading, the time and place for exchange of goods had to be standardized and was often made to coincide with the day when people were likely to congregate for a social or religious activity. In the case of the Peanut Fair, its location or the marking of territory were determined by the religious need of the peanut growers to offer their harvest at the Bull Temple. The periodicity of the fair may have grown out of the need to fix a mutually convenient time and place for people coming from different villages. At the fair, as there is no formal process for allocation of space, the vendors' first task is to mark their territory. The peanut growers arrive from outside Bangalore almost a week in advance to catch place on the street. They use gunny bags, ropes, and so on to demarcate their space. One finds that collective memory plays a key role in the marking of territory. One commonly hears, "We came here first, and therefore this space is ours." The temple authorities do not keep a written record of who can occupy what place every year. However, the priests have informally known some of the vendors and their families for many years. This familiarity helps some vendors get access to prime locations closer to the temple. Formal planning of the city continues to imagine space as a surface on which we are placed and makes little or no connection of space with time or with the activities that take place there.